Hello, it's Stephen here.
And Maria.
From Carter Fitness and Nutrition. Now, today's video will be based on debunking myths that are preventing you from losing body fat. So, let's crack on with the video.
Carbs after 6 p.m. Seriously, who believes this? Carbs are not a macro to fear, considering as they're really, really good and beneficial throughout the day, unless it was like fast food or sugary foods, then it's a bad then it would be a bad carb to have. But carbs only contain 4 calories per gram as well, so no, carbs are not do not make you fat any point of the day, so you don't have to worry in that case.
Next tip, keto is best for fat loss. Is keto best? Well, no. Keto is good, but I wouldn't suggest it is only a fat loss. And why is that? Ketosis is when you take your carbs out below 50 grams of carbs per day. Now, if you are decreasing your carbs that much, obviously you're going to feel lethargic. You're going to feel tired. So, in my opinion, no, keto is not the best option. You are best to include carbs in your fat loss diet. So, the good benefit of obviously being on a ketosis is you'll feel more full because there are more calories per gram in fats, slower digestion, and basically, overall, you're just going to feel like you don't want to eat too much because carbohydrates are more of a fast digesting food. They're the same as protein, as in calories, 4 calories per gram, but entirely fats and proteins just on their own are rather quite filling. So in my opinion, no, ketosis is not the best option when it comes to fat loss. It can be one of the worst when it comes to lethargic and being very tired all day, but I don't see it as an overall bad option to choose. So this depends on how you react with no carbs or low carb. It depends. There is a difference between low carb and ketosis. Ketosis below 50, low carb is 150 grams and below. So there's a bit of a difference in energy balance, but overall, I wouldn't suggest ketosis, but if you can deal with it, then do it.
Next tip, eat fat to burn fat. Fat in general contains 8 calories per gram. When it comes to losing fat, you want to eat the most satisfying but low calorie dense foods that aren't too heavy. When it comes to losing fat, you want the most satisfying yet low-dense foods that help you consume a bit more. Fat is better when you're looking at eating at a maintenance state and bulking rather than eating at a cutting state. So in general, fat does not burn fat.
Next tip, gaining fat after binge eating. So this is related basically to one binge eat. So you have one night where obviously you crash diet throughout the day and then you binge later on. Is that going to gain fat? No. Why does binge eating not gain fat? Well, obviously your body is capable of holding that into water weight, especially when you're eating whole high salty foods. So one binge, all that'll do is increase your entire body weight overnight and over the course of a few days, and eventually it will come off. So binge eating, even if it's 3,500, 4,000 calories over your maintenance, you will not gain fat in a single binge. So basically it's the same meaning as one binge will not make you fat, one day of dieting will not make you lose body fat. It's the same thing. So that's one, that is a myth. You will not gain fat if you binge one night.
Next tip is going to bed straight after eating. Some people believe if you go to bed straight after eating, you're going to put on fat. But the truth is you're not, because the least it's going to do is going to cause you some acid reflux, indigestion, or it'll bloat you. It's not going to make you fat.
Next tip, relying on detox. Now, if something says detox, or this will detox your liver or detox your body, doesn't mean it will. There are teas out there that says detox, there are flavored waters out there that says detox, there is even vitamin D things that say detox. Detoxification is when the body clears out toxins. Now, when the body is basically like after you've woken up from your sleep, your body's full of toxins. So what is your detoxification? Water. You consume water to basically flush out those toxins. Okay. Same as aloe vera. That can, to some extent, detox your body. Green tea, to some extent. Coffee, to some extent. But that's the thing. You can't rely on something that says it will detox your body. You can't just think, okay, I'm going to use this because it helped you lose weight, it helped you feel better, but it won't. So what you got to do is eat in a caloric deficit, stay consistent, do your cardio, do your weightlifting, right? And if you want to have some detox drinks like coffee and that, yeah, that's a great idea, good for the liver. But overall, I would not rely on detoxification. A lot of it is a load of bollocks.
Right, the next tip is fasting fat loss. The reason why this isn't good is because you'll be fasted for a long period of time, and when you go back to eating, you'll be eating in a bulk, so you'll end up having more calories than you would normally have. So say you normally have 1,000 calories. Because you would have been fasted, you'll probably end up going over that. But I'm not saying it's entirely bad. Some people, fasted state, it could work well. Some people, it doesn't work well. So if it works well for you, then perfect. But if not, then don't do it. For some reason, people believe that all calories are equal, but in fact they're not. You get high and you get low calorie dense foods. For instance, you got fast food and you got average food. When I say that, fast food, you got breaded chicken. And then what they do, they've got the breaded battered chicken, which isn't really low calories, that's too high in calories. And then you've got normal chicken breast, and that's really good in calories. That's not too high like the fast food chicken breast. Well, I wouldn't really class it as chicken breast, it's more breaded than anything else. I recently became a brand ambassador of jogger sportswear. Material is fantastic. It's squat proof and it helps flatter your body in the right places. It comes in blue, pink and black. You can get single shorts like I did, or you can get sports bra, or you can get full body leggings. On the jogger website you can use my 20% discount code in the bottom link below. I'll put it in the link below and you can use that. Thank you.
Next tip. Relying on supplements to help you lose weight. Now, supplements in general, they are there to help you supplement your diet. Using them alone will not help in any case to help you lose body fat. You have supplements like L-carnitine, you have omega-3s, you have vitamin D that do play a big major role in helping you to lose body fat, but with the diet. Using them alone won't do nothing. So, what sort of supplements would I recommend? Of course, I'd recommend supplements like omega-3, I would definitely recommend vitamin D, multivitamin. I would 100% recommend like turmeric, caffeine, okay, pre-work, like any type kind of pre-workout, anything like that, whey protein, anything that can help you reach your goals. But working them alone is not possible, so no. With supplements, doesn't work on its own, so yeah, that's a big bad myth. Don't rely on supplements alone.
Thank you for watching.
Yes, thank you very much for watching our video. I hope you enjoyed every moment. I hope you found the tips useful.
Please like and subscribe.
And follow our Instagram at CarterFitness90. And we'll see you in the next one.